are some of my likes. Puns, olives, country music, cheese, and swing dancing. Here are some of my dislikes. Gum chewing, lentils, and being cold.
Yuck.
Yuck. You can have whatever kind of life that you want. If you can dream it up, you can absolutely have it, no matter how many times people told you you couldn't do it, no matter how many times you have felt inside that it's not possible and you'll never have the kind of life you want or never make it in the way that you want. You can absolutely have the life that you want as long as you believe that it's possible. You have to first just believe that you can have it in order to have it, and after you do that, it's absolutely possible. Battery.
Mm-hmm.
How would that have possibly happened?
I don't. That's. And how do we troubleshoot that?
Are the lights working? Are the gauges working? Are any other lights on in the RV?
Should we try jump starting with this thing?
Sure.
I'm just frustrated. It feels like I don't know how we're gonna just be able to afford to keep doing this.
I mean, I know it's fine. I know it's gonna be fine. It's just, and then it just brings up like, fuck, like what are we gonna do when we get back? And you know, what's the next round gonna look like?
I know.
What are we doing with our lives? It just like spins off into like ridiculous places. You know, it's like, and who's ever gonna want somebody who doesn't have their shit together, you know? You know, and here's another like $400 2 weeks before we go home in an RV that's not even ours. You know, we spent over $2,000 just fixing this thing, and then, you know, almost $3,000 just to rent it. It's like,
it's crazy.
A shitload of money.
Yeah, it is.
I know that's the risk. I know that's what we got into. It's not that. It's just frustrating. I just don't know how it's gonna all work out.
Do you guys want to come over here? I'm sorry to, but so I can see both of you and you guys can talk to each other. Would that be okay?
Yeah. Fucking A. Ugh, I'm just so frustrated right now.
I know. I know. I think I'm just scared. I don't know what we're doing next. I don't know what I want to do.
This trip is coming to an end. So what the fuck now, huh?
Yeah. It's great to have a cause and to be doing something, and then when that's over, what are we doing?
What do you think it is that, like, scares you the most about it?
Well, I think it's just that feeling of, like, I don't know what I want to do with my life. Or, like, the next couple years, you know? And I just, it's like, I know it's so stupid, but I feel too old to feel that way, to not know, you know, to still be figuring it out. I feel stupid, you know? To not have something solid that I feel like I'm working towards, you know, because it changes all the time. Coach, up here, puppy. Load up.
In there?
Yep.
Great. All right, you can pull it on forward just a little bit now.
All right, into the bay?
You just get close to those tires.
Okay.
I said these haven't been off in a while. Sir.
So we're here in Joplin, the place of a huge tornado earlier this year, and we are giving coffee to the construction workers in the site that was hit the hardest by the tornado. The warmth of your love's like the warmth from the sun, and this will be our year, took a long time to come. Don't let go of my hand, now the darkness has gone. This will be our year, took a long time to come. And I won't forget the way you helped me up when I was down. And I won't forget the way you said, darling, I love you. You gave me faith to go. This will be our year, took a long time to come. The warmth of your smile, smile for me, little one. And this will be our year, took a long time to come. You don't have to worry.
Cracked. Do you see cracks in it?
No.
Well, I was thinking like the this area.
What is that?
It's definitely with the water pump somehow.
Dripping out from underneath the seam at the top here.
I mean, that's obviously clean water.
Yeah.
It's not the...
It's not coming from the tank.
But I don't know whatever there is above it, if that's where the pump is right here. If you have access to that area. And this is obviously where it's to fill something up. So it may just go all the way over to the tank.
Yeah. I can go in there and check it. There is a pump. The water pump actually is right kind of there. So the water leak is now leaking all the way into the hallway.
Uh-oh.
That's the gray one.
That's just the storage box.
Wait, maybe this is the drain. I don't know what this drain is.
We need to see what's leaking on it.
What's actually causing the leak.
What's actually causing the leak.
This is love. This is love. This is love. This is love. This is love.
Brighten up the morning with your smile so big.
Broke down again, and it really frustrated me, and I got really disheartened. And basically, the series of events that happened in my head that led me to crying were, great, the car's breaking down, I'm gonna have to pay for that, where am I gonna get the money for that, my business, okay, well, what's going on with my business? Then it was, well, what are we doing next? And then it's, I don't know,
and then I got really scared. And the one that really hit me the hardest was, and then nobody's going to want to be with me when I don't know what I'm doing with my life. And I felt messy.
So this pretty much led to us really looking at this topic or the subject of the unknown and being afraid of the unknown. And both of us have been thinking about that in our own ways and wanted to have a conversation about mm-hmm. this thing called the fear of the unknown.
The unknown, it has always been really terrifying to me, so much so that I'll try to avoid it. So I'll try to either make plans that I think are known and I'm never happy with them because they're not actually what I really want to do, right. but they feel known, so I go for it. Or I look for outside sources to make me feel like I have some sort of known plan.
When we're really in whatever we're doing, when we're like super absorbed and focused on, you know, whether it was a building GGM or being on the road, all of that stuff kind of goes away because we're in action. Even though in that we might not know what tomorrow brings, because we usually don't know what tomorrow brings. Like, that's part of the awesomeness of it, like the spontaneity. Every morning we get to decide. But since we're moving and we're in action around it, all the other stuff does kind of go away. We're not as worried about mm-hmm. those things.
Yeah. And that actually led me to start thinking about the idea that joy and happiness has to come from within yourself. Mm-hmm. Real true joy and happiness. And I'm not exactly sure how that happens yet, but it's just right now an observation of, you know, it's not the outside things that can make us happy or not make us happy. It's just mm-hmm. that we reach for them when we're feeling scared.
In those moments of feeling all crazy and scared and feeling like you don't have a grasp on anything, the thing that I realize is, you know, this control, this idea of, like, I don't have control over things. But there is control. Like, I'm in control of my choice, and I'm in control of the way I react to things. And I might not be in control of that initial reaction, you know, like, obviously, we're gonna get frustrated, the thing isn't starting, and then it spirals into, like, money, and so we might not be in control of, like, the initial reaction that we have, and that's okay, but we do have control over the next reaction, which is, okay, I can now realize, what are my options, what are my choices, what do I want to do with that? I can decide to take the next step in this direction, or this direction.
What if you don't know what step that you want to take next?
But is it you don't know what step to take next, or you don't know what direction to go in?
Either.
Because the direction, the end goal, I'm pretty sure most of us know what we want our end goal to look like or feel like, you know? So, no. Okay, Kat's saying no. She doesn't.
I think agree that that's with Kat. True.
Okay. So.
I've been thinking a lot about this because this is actually where I'm at right now. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a lot of things I can think of that would make me happy or I think would make me happy. There's a million different things that I like. Mm-hmm. You know, I think, okay, I can open a really cool artist community trailer park hotel and that would be awesome. Or I can start a school for teenage girls about how to, like, be a good friend and how to live a good life and how to have healthy relationships. And then there's, you know, like, oh, let's open a store or a wine and cheese bar. And it's, like, all over the place. Mm-hmm. And I feel really fickle about everything. You know, like, okay, I like this for a couple months and I like that for a year. But nothing seems to feel very lasting. And then I feel, like, wobbly about life.
Well, see, and I go, and I'm coming from this place of, like, you know, that whole statement of, like, the only thing that's constant is change, you know, to think that there's going to be something that you're going to do for the next 20 years of your life, I think is kind of, it might be real for some people, but I don't know if it's real for everybody. I don't know if it fits or it resonates for everybody. There are the people that are the fire starters. There are the people that are the managers, that are the day-to-day. There are the people that, you know, organize the whole thing. And you, to me, are a fire starter. You know, you're the one that has the great ideas and get it up and running, like the entrepreneur. It doesn't mean that your job is to be there till completion, you know, and to embrace that about yourself. And I'm talking to myself, too. You know that. Like, you know that I'm in that same place, too, of
you know, I think up to like 60% is awesome. And then I'm like, okay, can someone else do the other like 40%? Because that's not my strength. It's like, it's a combination of like finding out what your strengths are, finding out the things that you love to do, and realizing that every day you can do those things and start just walking. Because we get so scared that we don't even walk. We don't even take any action. And then we're just paralyzed with fear. But just start walking. Things will open up. Things will get clearer. Things will, you know, illuminate themselves. And you'll make connections that might take you in a totally different path. But you're walking. You're heading towards something. Fear of the unknown, it's not like that ever goes away. We were talking about that the other day.
Well, I was just going to say that it does, not only does it not go away, but 100% of life is unknown. Even, like you said, if you can even have a plan, and it could be perfectly worked out fine, mm-hmm. and then one day, something changes it completely that you have absolutely no control over. And so, it's this funny thing that we do as humans, is to want to know so badly that we just freak out about it our whole lives.
Yeah.
But the real truth is that we can't know. We can't know any of it. We don't, we won't.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing. It's like, I feel like once I embrace that piece, it's not like that fear doesn't come up every once in a while, but I freak out less about it. Like, I freak out way less about it now than I did a couple of years ago.
So what I've got out of this conversation already is that all of life is unknown, and all of us worry about that and get scared. The more that we can accept that our life is unknown, the better off we are, at least the less stress we are about it.
Yeah.
And all we can really do is keep taking steps in the direction of what feels right to us, and ultimately we'll end up in the place that we need to be. Is that that big ass thing right next to you?
This? This thing? Yeah, that's it. That's it, alright.
What are you gonna do with it?
Anything I want to.
Or chastity belts.
What else could we do with it? The cast if I break my arm?
Oh! Those like butt cut things, your butt would look way bigger. I got a dunk dunk butt. Alright, let's put our hard hats on and go.
Let's go, ladies.
Go.
You guys ready?
Go. I'm like reporting for work, sir.
How's it taste? It
tastes like spring water. From the Appalachian Mountains.
Let's bottle that shit and sell it.
Yeah. GGM needs money. We'll do whatever it takes.
You know, we're ready.
Okay.
I think it's a girl. Because...
Because it's a private area?
Yeah.